Our opening song this morning is Amazing Grace, number 446 in your missalette. Please stand.
Us all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Mary died with Christ and now rises with him to a new life. May she now share the Lord's eternal glory. As this white cloth now covers the casket, may it serve to remind us all of the clothing of the saints which Mary now shares. May the procession to the altar of God have reminded us as well of the entrance of Mary into the kingdom of heaven, sharing the food of life at the table of God's children forever.
We will now have the eulogy. I will begin by speaking on behalf of my family and expressing our sincere thank you for your presence here today, as well as flowers, food, donations, and thoughts and prayers. Most of all, thank you for remembering our beautiful mother. How can I begin to sum up 88 years of Mom's long and productive life in just a few paragraphs? Our mom, a wonderful lady, wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, aunt, friend, and loving child of God. Mom was born to Arthur and Eva Simon in 1934 in the middle of the Great Depression. Maybe this is how or why she and her 9 brothers and sisters grew to be hard workers and to appreciate all they were given in life, even in the most difficult of times. After helping to raise younger brothers and sisters and being the angel of the family, as she always told us, Mom married Dad at the age of 18. Soon after, 6 children were given life. She would often remind the rest of us that she had 6 children by the age of 29. Mom and Dad provided us with years of growing up in a family where love, hard work, and a sense of humor was the norm. Mom was a wife and mother of the 50s, where she learned to serve the needs of her husband and family before her own. Being a wife of a farmer meant a lot of hard work, but she seemed to enjoy almost every minute. We did not have much, and yet we had everything. Mom provided us with love and encouragement, served us 3 home-cooked meals a day, and kept us organized and looking somewhat presentable. And I'll tell you, no one was a better cook than she, especially when it came to her blackberry pie, roast beef, mashed potatoes, chocolate cake, and Jell-O. She would keep us in line with her sometimes colorful words and phrases and occasional chases around the house with the yardstick. Sometimes when we'd get on her last nerve and we could tell she'd reached the limit, and one of us would have to take charge to put that beautiful smile back on her face. Usually that would be Dad with his off-the-wall jokes. And if that didn't work, and I'm not sure how or when we discovered this, but Mark could take a table knife and swing it like a pendulum back and forth in front of her face, and you know, next thing you know, she would begin laughing hysterically until her teeth would fall out. Whatever it took, this seemed to lighten the mood for everybody. Mom always taught us that to earn a little free time, one must first put in some hard work. We learned to weed the garden and hill the potatoes in record time just to be able to earn a swim in the pond. You provided us with a great work ethic. Growing up on a dairy farm meant no long summer vacations. However, we did get to take quick day trips occasionally to the zoo and even the state fair, especially when one of our 4-H projects made it that far. One of the highlights of the special trips would include a lunch picnic of Mom's delicious fried chicken. Sunday church was always a big deal, as well as a celebration. The weekly ritual of bathing, putting hair into rollers, ironing clothes, including brothers' cassettes and surfers, polishing shoes, and making ourselves look our best would be followed by us scurrying and packing into the car. Mom was always a multitasker and would turn around to make a final look at us, lick her fingers, straighten kids' stray hair, and wipe away any smudges we may have missed, and then turn back around to tell Dad to hurry because there was not another soul on the road. And then, as if that weren't enough, she'd proceed to ask if there was any fallen hair on her back. We usually seem to make it just before the start of the first song. One of Mom and Dad's proudest accomplishments were their grandchildren. Oh, how they loved and celebrated all their achievements, and suffered if they were suffering. They were thankful for every one of them. Regrettably, her great-grandchildren would never really get to know the woman behind the shell of the person she once was. As many of you know, Mom suffered from dementia, which continued to worsen during the past several years. Although that terrible disease took much of her zest and personality, it did not take away her sweetness nor her love for her family and religion. Mom continued to pray faithfully each and every day. If we called or happened to stop in and check on her, she would be saying the rosary or her bag of prayers. Even in her final days of life, she would ask if it was too late to get ready for church. You are at peace now, Mom. We want to say thank you for all you've given us. We will miss you and your beautiful smile for sure. Tell Dad hello and that we miss him every single day. We will always love you both. Until we meet again, please continue to pray for us and guide us from above. Writer Mitch Albom reminds us in this quote, "Death ends a life, not a relationship." Mom and Dad, we consider ourselves so very blessed for the wonderful relationships you provided us. Your love for God and family set a great example for all of us, and it shows in our everyday family. Thank you.
From the grandchild perspective, there's 20 of us. And growing up next to Grandma had so many, we were just blessed and lucky. We were blessed and lucky to have you as a grandmother in so many facets of our life. We've learned so many great qualities from you, your devotion to your faith, your love for your family, and the tidiness of your house, just to name a few. With that being said, Grandma and Grandpa got new carpet, and you all know how Grandma loved to keep the house clean. Unfortunately, one of us grandchildren were not feeling the best, so Grandma, being resourceful and not wanting to get that carpet dirty, laid saran wrap from the guest bedroom all the way to the bathroom. That's just a little taste of how clean Grandma liked to keep her house. Grandma always had a cold cookie from the freezer. You want a cookie? She would grab into the freezer, and always a glass of milk or tea ready for us when we stopped by. She knew that we liked Kool-Aid, but she didn't have any Kool-Aid packets. Instead, she filled up a pitcher of cold water and dumped in a packet of Jell-O. No matter whenever you stopped by, Grandma always had a piece of candy at all times, from dots to butterscotch to hard candies to you name it. If you stopped by and you had your report card, and you had an A, you got a quarter for every A you had on your report card. If you were ever lucky enough to have Grandma give you a bath as a kid, your ears have never been cleaner. I swear when she would clean my ears that she was touching my brain. You would come out of that bathtub with whiplash. When you did spend the night with Grandma and Grandpa as a kid, we would always get Grandma laughing and joking, and then we would ask her to pop her teeth out, and we thought that that was the funniest thing. And we would giggle so hard. We also thought that it was funny if we toilet papered Grandma and Grandpa in the nighttime. And as exhilarating as it was for us as grandchildren, Grandma and Grandpa got just as big a kick out of it as we did. Grandma always had such a beautiful singing voice. Everyone wanted to sit next to her in church just to hear her sing. We love you, Grandma, and are happy you are reunited with Grandpa. The matriarch of the Gillen family has carried her rugged cross, has now gone to heaven, and gained a crown. Rest in peace, Grandma. We love you.
Grandma was always a faithful servant to Jesus and his mother Mary. 70 years ago, when she married Grandpa, she placed a bouquet of palm mums at the foot of Mary. She has prayed faithfully to her every day since then. Today again, we honor our blessed mother by placing this bouquet at Mary's feet.
Please join me in singing number 700 in your songbook on this day, O Beautiful Mother.
On this day, trusting thy gentle care.
Let us pray. Into your hands, O Lord, we humbly entrust Mary. In this life, you embraced her with your tender love. Deliver her now from every evil and bid her eternal rest with you. For the old order passes away. Welcome her now into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, no weeping or pain, but the fullness of peace and joy with your Son Jesus and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Please be seated now for our readings.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She rises while it is still night and distributes food to her household. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs at the days to come. She opens her mouth in wisdom, and on her tongue is kindly counsel. Her children rise up and praise her. Her husband, too, extols her. Many are the women of proven worth, but you have excelled them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these, you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? For you, why do you look down on your brother? or we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then, each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Jesus Christ, whose return we long for, will come from heaven to save us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to Jesus, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am your way, the truth of your life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know the way. These words are from our Gospel this morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hearing that eulogy, surely, and a woman who touched so many lives in so many wonderful ways, I'm sure that's what brings you all here today, remembering all these wonderful things about this person. Well, today, it's always good that we find ourselves in a church where we are remembering such a person, the life that they lived. And what about any other life? Is that all there is, the life that they lived here on this earth? We get a chance to think about the pattern that God created when he created our world, when he created each and every one of us. For God is a spirit, an eternal spirit. And when God creates, he does everything perfectly. Well, he created all these spirits from his own. There was nothing before God. There's nothing after God. There is just God and everything that is. So basically, we come from God. We are a part of God, revealing his goodness to the world, creating good things as God creates. As scripture says, God saw it was all good. Well, that's our reason for being here. That's why God created us in the first place. Created us as spirits. And Our parents participated in all this creation by creating a material body that that spirit now inhabits as it walks through the world, encountering all kinds of experiences and people and challenges and everything else that life is about. But there comes a time where the spirit once again separates from that body. Jesus even said, material things don't last. So don't put who you are in some material thing as if this is me. No, it's not. We are a spirit that lives forever as God Himself lives forever. We come from Him and we return to Him, Jesus said. Now, there's a nice little saying about that when we die, we move from one home here on this earth to another. But I think it's more appropriate to say that we return to the home from which we came. And indeed, that home with God is filled with, well, all kinds of wonderful things we have yet to experience. But we can have some indication of that in the home, so to speak, that we create for everybody around us. And indeed, Mary created a wonderful home for so many people. I mean, when I looked at her obituary, all her children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren, and she even worked in a school and touching the lives of all kinds of kids, who knows in how many ways. And we all touch the lives of each other in many ways. Well, so it is today that we remember this person who is still very much alive. Yes, the material body, it doesn't last, but Jesus says it will be recreated someday at the very end of time. Only this time, Jesus said, it'll be like his own that we see after Easter when Jesus was going around visiting everybody, creating a body and then disappearing and uncreating it. And it will have all kinds of other qualities more befitting our spirit. Well, until that time, we say we have memories of a person. But actually, we have more than that. We have a person who's alive and who, out of her love, and love always brings things together, brings things close. Well, she's going to be close to all those that she loved here on this earth. You know, some ask, well, why do we have to die? Why this wonderful person is taken away from us? Well, I think that's part of God's plan. That this person who provided all these wonderful things and all this great example shouldn't be someone we depend upon to be doing all those nice things. It's now my turn to do those things. And so, based on what we've learned, well, we need to go out and create, because that's why God put us here in the first place, to create good things for everyone around us. So today we are thankful for someone who did that for all of us. I'm sure Mary is here, and spirits, they could be, they're outside of space and time like God is. They can, just like Jesus in his body after Easter, could be any place at any time, and some places, multiple places at the same time. I mean, it's just a whole different kind of way of living. But spirits do communicate through love, through feelings. And I'm sure Mary will continue to reach out to all whom she loves You know, when you think, oh, I just happened to be thinking about her today, maybe it was because Mary was there trying to communicate to me. Maybe it's more than just coincidence. We can be sure that it probably is, because God's love is always calling us to Himself, as now Mary understands that so well. You know the way. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us now stand as once again we bring our needs to our Father in heaven.
For Mary, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of Mary's family, especially her husband Don and her brothers and sisters, that they may have the reward of their goodness with God and all the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living members of Mary's family, especially her children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren, that they remain faithful to their Catholic faith and always follow the ways of the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family life and family values, may God protect all families and bestow upon them the grace to become more united as a family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an abundance of harvest blessings and for the safety of all farmers as they harvest their crops, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people Mary blessed during her lifetime, through her goodness, kindness, and gentle spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, our country, our families, and in our own lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, may your love truly be felt by all those who love Mary in this life, for indeed your love is forever and ever. Please be seated now as our gifts are brought forward. Thank you. Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise, the glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Mary may be taken up into the glory with your Son. For it is in the great mystery of love that we all are united. For we ask this through Christ the Lord, who lives one God forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that always, everywhere, we give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, for it is in Jesus that the hope of our blessed resurrection has been made visible for the world to see, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is always changing, but it is never ending. And when this earthly dwelling of ours turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so with angels and archangels and all the saints, we praise you once again as we sing. Of all holiness, make holy once again these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, and that they may become for all of us the body, the blood of Jesus Christ. For at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more he gave you thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, we celebrate this memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, this bread of life, this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you call us to be with you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by his Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout our world. Bring us to the fullness of love, together with Francis our Pope, Charles our Bishop, and all who you call to be your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who die in Christ. Welcome them now into the light of your face, as we remember your servant Mary, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her loving spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, they have pleased you throughout the ages, that we all may merit to be with them in eternal life, praising and glorifying you, surrounded by your light and love of the joys of the kingdom of heaven. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor is yours forever and ever. As we remember someone who indeed provided daily bread as God does, let us pray again as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from every distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming again of our living Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of all in your church. Graciously grant to each of us peace and unity, for that is in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Always, as we experience the goodness of God expressed in one another, surely it brings peace for us all. Maybe a little sign of peace with everyone. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen for all women. Shining one, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom. Teach us love. Blessed are you among women. Blessed in turn all women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits. Blessed they with gentle hearts. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love.
The minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her sitting on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I've seen your flag on the marble arch. Love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Quite a tribute to Mary. You know, I hope the gates of heaven are well oiled because there's been so many Simons going in and out these days. But, you know, it's wonderful that so many wonderful people show us all the way. Let us now stand and pray. Lord God, Jesus left us in the sacrament of his body and blood food for our journey to the kingdom of heaven. Mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Mary may now come to live in the eternal home of Jesus himself, for he is with us always, forever and ever. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Mary, and now we come to this farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Mary again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation may leave with sorrow in their hearts, the mercy of God gathers us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with the message of Jesus Christ. Raise it up, the whole thing. Raise up the whole thing.
That's it. May the choirs of angels come to greet you. Speed you to paradise. May the me from harm. The Lord is the strength of my days. Before whom should I tremble with fear? May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Mary in this sure and certain hope that together with all who die in Christ, Mary will rise with Jesus on that last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Mary in this life, for they are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise for your servant Mary, and help us who remain here on this earth to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Mary forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May the angels come to lead you into paradise, Mary. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In peace, let us now take our sister Mary to her place of rest.
Our closing song is number 437 in your songbook, On Eagle's Wings.
Lest you dash your foot against a stone.